tell you, they call themselves the Long Riders, appropriately dressed. Right, you're standing in my way. Didn't know
that? Yes, I know I am, because people want to see me and not you. And I'm going to tell these people out here one thing. The way you see us is the way God made us. This is our hair. These are our bodies. We didn't have to go and spend a lot of money on some things and then spend a lot of time in the gym. And those people out there know what those things are I'm talking about. Saying, get these great, big, beautiful bodies out. People, we are this way naturally. We're nothing made up in the gym.
That's it. You know, you people out there, you see the road warriors, you see them with their painted faces, you see them with their big boots, and you get out of their way, and you see us with our long hair and our long coats riding down the road.
Let's get the road warriors.
Hey, don't interfere when I'm talking.
I have to give equal time to the road warriors.
You people will stay out of the way.
I'm calling the road warriors in here right now.
The road warriors wouldn't dare step in.
Precious Paul.
Don't worry.
The road warriors won't be here. They won't be here.
Don't you give me back my microphone. Precious Paul, I need the road warriors in here. They won't come on now.
That's right. Because we have nicknamed them. The road warriors, the road runners. And now, tonight, we got them in the ring. We finally catching up with the road runners. And we're going to take care of them tonight. We're going to see, people, who the best tag team is in the AWA.
All right. The road warriors say that they're going to do their talking in the ring. They won't come out. They'll come in ringside. Lee, back up to you.
All right, Mike, and thank you very much. We look forward to that match a little bit later on. That should be pretty interesting. All right, looks like the Long Riders and the Road Warriors are going to be ready for an interesting match, and we're going to see that in just a few minutes. Stay tuned.
I don't know if we can explain that match, but we do know coming up we have the Road Warriors against the Long Riders.
Long Riders are in for a beating tonight at the hands of the Legion of Doom. And let me tell you something, boys. Tonight's the night, and we're putting the coals to you. Tell them, big man.
That's right, Long Riders. You're a big man, and you're tough. You've been beating everybody. Well, in a few seconds, we're going to show you what we're made of.
All right. I wouldn't miss it. Stay with us. We'll be right back with Wrestling for a Cure right here on Channel 5. Stay with us. You work on it at all, B66?
Well, I'll tell you the truth. Actually, I grew up in Somerville, so wrestling isn't a sport. It was a way of life. So I'm just trying to pick up a few tips next time I visit my friends back home again.
All right, the Road Warriors and the Long Riders set to go. Let's go back upstairs to Lee Wood.
Mike, you won't believe what just happened. If we can go down to the ring right now, the Long Riders were in there, and then the Road Warriors came on, and all heck broke loose before the match even started. Order has now been restored. We hope we can begin the match officially. What a scene down there. All right, let's go to our celebrity ring announcer, the voice of the Boston Celtics, Johnny Most.
In that corner from Deloitte, Minnesota, weighing 270 and 290 pounds, the challengers, Scott Hog Irwin and Wild Bill Irwin of the Long Riders. And from Chicago's south side, weighing 290 and 270 pounds respectively, the present AWA Tag Team Champions, Animal and Hawk, and their manager, Precious Paul.
By coming into the ring and can't even talk. I'm so excited.
It's dangerous. Even dangerous for the announcers. Boy, they have to get out there in a hurry.
I'll tell you, Kane is all right. Johnny Most, because the Road Warriors really are animals. One's Animal, one's Hawk, managed by Precious Paul Ellering. And there has been pandemonium here, and the match just started about a moment ago.
In fact, the match started even before the bell rang. As soon as he walked in the ring, the match started.
I mean, I was proud to see Johnny Most get a standing ovation, but he got out of the ring really fast. Jess Kane got in, announced it, and boy, he was banged, and I hope Jess is all right. In the meantime, the tag team champions of the AWA are in against the Long Riders. Here comes Hawk Irwin, 270 pounds. He gets a headbutt from the Hawk, another headbutt right in the face from the Hawk. And here comes what a strategic move called for by Paul Ellering.
You know what I'm noticing? They have very unusual haircuts, don't they, the Road Warriors?
A nice right foot, like a karate chop. Look like PKA boxing out there. Boy, I got caught by surprise. When this match started, there were so many people in the ring, celebrities, announcers, and all these Road Warriors want to do is wrestle.
The safest place was here, sitting right here with you, Eddie.
I hope so.
Unless they come out now and try to do us a little stuff, I wouldn't like that at all.
Here goes Hawk Irwin, a flying elbow.
They
almost won the championship. And here's Precious Paul Ellering, their manager, and he has got a rolled up copy of the racing form. They're trying to make the tag right now, Killer. But he's not going to get it. And here comes Wild Bill, 290 pounds. Wonder what his body fat is.
A flying knee drop.
Right to the kisser.
Choking him on the ropes. That's illegal. Referee can interfere on that one.
How can a 160-pound referee contain 580 pounds of dynamite?
Really can't, but the wrestlers are afraid of getting disqualified, so do have to pay attention to referee to some extent. That's what happened last time, last match there, against Bobby Backlund, with Larry Zbyszko disqualified.
Wrestling for a Cure for Matthews Arena. Put some muscle behind it and support the Channel 5 Telethon, Jerry's Kids Labor Day weekend. That's what this is all about.
Support WHDH2.
We have, right now, Animal and Hawk getting themselves tested here a little bit by the Pale Riders. But the outcome is almost inevitable. This is like the Anvil Chorus. Almost the cover. That was Hawk Irwin, 270 pounds, and his big brother Wild Bill is waiting for a tag against Animal. And, of course, Hawk.
Oh, in the eyes.
How'd you like that? I mean, he's saying, hey, referee, I didn't do anything but stick my fingers in his eyeballs.
Well, they broke clean. That's unusual. Now what's going to happen here?
Famous flying tushy sit.
A tushy sit. That's
a tushy sit. Oh.
They're calling the new name for her. The real name for that was the flying leg drop. Headlock by the Long Rider.
There's a lot of strategy in tag team wrestling, right?
That's right, because, you know, you have to watch out not only for the guy you're watching wrestling, but your opponent also, the one in the corner. Sometimes they team up and have two against one of them. And sometimes four against four. Sometimes six against six. They have six-man tag matches, too.
Here's a arm twist. We used to call that an Indian grin when I was a kid in Dorchester.
Well, you wrestled when you were a kid, too, huh? Wow. You might have been a great wrestler if you could have continued with a career instead of going with WHBH.
Left hook to the jaw that Marvin Hagler would have been proud of.
That was a clothesline. Looked like a clothesline again.
What a smash that was. And there's a left to the gut, but he looks pretty powerful there and a head drop. And now here comes Wild Bill in. He's doing a job on Hawk right now. Wild Bill looks like he's been on Bob Stanley's diet. All right, here comes the animal now. Here comes the animal. Oh, and a flying headbutt. And another flying headbutt. And the animal is taking on both of the Pale Riders. He doesn't need any help. He missed the right hook. And now it looks like there might be a pin if the ref is on the ball. One, two, three. The Road Warriors maintain their title.
The referee, Bob Shulp, and one of the match for the Road Warriors.
And Precious Paul Ellerin, their manager, he's doing a great job. I'm hoping we can get the wrestlers over here for a minute. We're not going to be able to get them over here.
Tell the Road Warriors we'd like to interview them.
I wanted to tell the Road Warriors how much I admire them and Paul Ellerin, because I got to tell you, Killer, they really put on a show. They're rough, tough customers.
It seems like it take an axe to try to stop the Road Warriors, but the Long Riders did a pretty good job, trying to contain them, but just they didn't do enough of a job.